Hello. Just wanted to walk you guys through the audition music so that everybody can get a nice preparation, have a nice audition. Auditions are going to start on the on May 20th, which is the Monday after start testing is over. It's the second to last week of school. So let me walk you through the music. This is the same for all instruments. First thing you want to take a look at is the key signature. We're in the key of concert F. So flute, oboe, bassoon, trombone, euphonium, tuba, percussion. That is going to be a B flat for you, and you also have E natural and A natural. If you're a B flat instrument, that's going to be clarinet and trumpet. Then you have an F sharp and a B natural. Alto sax, you have F sharp and C sharp, and so be watching out for that. Horns are actually using the same audition music as the trumpets are using, and so you're in the key of concert C, and you have an F sharp and a B natural as well. The time signature for the piece is 3/4 time. And so that means there are going to be 3 beats per measure. We could have 3 quarter notes, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Or we could start, as you'll see, the first measure of it is a half note with a quarter note, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. We may have a dotted half note, which is going to fill up the measure, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Or we may see a measure of eighth notes, 1 and 2 and 3 and, 1 and 2 and 3 and. There are lots of varieties for how these can be mixed up, and so just do your best. Make sure you spend some time counting and clapping, and especially if you aren't used to playing in 3/4 time. The song is split up into several sections. It's what we would call a theme and variation. So the theme is the main statement of the melody, and then the variations are going to change little aspects of it and further complicate the piece. You can get 25 points per section that you play on the audition. So if you only feel comfortable playing the theme, which is really short, then you can get a total of 25 points for that part. Somebody who plays the theme and the variation will get 50 points. Somebody who plays theme variation 1 and 2, they'll get a total possible 75 points, and so on. If you play the entire thing, you can get up to 125 points. So the more that you play, the more possible points you can get, and you can elect to stop whenever you want to. All right, let's take a look at some of the variations. In the first variation, you're going to notice the main idea here is that we want to play it smoothly with dynamics. So watch out for where your slurs are. In fact, the theme is going to focus on that also, smooth with dynamics. But make sure you're paying attention to where your slurs are. We have some crescendos. It starts piano, which is soft. There's a crescendo in the third measure of the first variation. And then it gets to MF, which is mezzo forte, and then there's another crescendo and a decrescendo and so on. Variation 2 has some more dynamics written in. Just make sure you're watching out for that. Also, you'll notice that there are a few more accidentals that are thrown in with variation 2. Once we get to the third variation, then we have these mixtures of 16th note patterns. So if we have just one beat that's 16th notes, we would say 1E and a. 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, if the whole measure were like that. The first time we are confronted with 16th notes, we'll see this dotted 8th 16th note pattern. And so a dotted 8th is equal to 3 16th notes. And then this last one will be the of that beat. So 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a. If you had a whole measure of it, that's how that would work out. Okay. Later on in that same measure, you will notice this pattern, an 8th note plus 2 16th notes. An 8th note is equal to 2 16th notes, and so we would think 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 3E and a. Or you could leave out the E and just say 1 and a, 2 and a, 3 and a, 1. And that would be a fine way to interpret that. Then towards the end, this is the third measure of the fourth variation. You'll see that we have this. It's 2 16ths and an 8th note. So that's going to be 1, E, and then this 8th note is going to be equal to the last 2 16th notes. So 1, E, and a, 2, E, and a, 3, E, and a. Or if you just omit the 1, E, and, 2, E, and, 3, E, and. Okay? Let me go ahead and play through the piece for you now. And obviously, if you have any questions on this music, then feel free to ask us in class, but for the most part, we want you to prepare this on your own. It's going to be more similar to what you do in our performing bands next year. Oh, the tempo is marked at 80, which is this fast. it's okay to stop in between the variations. Don't take a long time, but you could take a moment or two. Here's variation one. Variation three is when the extra technique comes in. Hope that helps. Feel free to ask us any questions if you have them in class time.